Welcome to part 2 of our tutorial on rendering light fields from reconstructed 3D meshes using the free and open source COLIBRI VR package for the Unity game engine. In this second part, I'll be showing you how to render our input images and 3D mesh with view-dependent rendering effects in real time and in virtual reality. The image-based rendering algorithm we'll be using here is called unstructured lumigraph rendering. And the general idea is that as the user moves around in the virtual environment, we update the rendered view to more accurately reflect what the user would have seen from this viewpoint in the original real-world scene. To do so, we interpolate the visual information from the input images using the recovered geometry as a proxy, and give more weight to images taken from an angle similar to that of the user's current viewpoint. To use this blending method, we're going to process our input data to create several virtual assets. First, a texture array that combines all of our input images, so you can click on Texture Array from Color Data. Second, the reconstructed 3D mesh, so you can click on Global Mesh from Existing File. And in part 1, we showed you how to reconstruct this mesh using CoolMap, but you can specify any 3D mesh here, so if you prefer to use another reconstruction toolkit, you can. And finally, we'll be using Purview Depth to perform depth correction for the unstructured lumigraph rendering algorithm. So you can click on Purview Depth as Texture Array, and this will recover one depth map per input viewpoint based on the recovered 3D mesh. We now launch Play Mode, click on Process Source Data, yes on the pop-up, and wait for this to finish. Processing is now finished. This took about 30 seconds on my setup. We now have a processed data folder in our main folder that contains our processed assets. We can now exit play mode and click on Bundle Processed Data. Bundling took about 1 minute on my setup. We now have a bundled data folder, which is where the data will be loaded from for rendering. Let's now add a rendering component to our game object. And we can specify our rendering method, so let's select ULR on Global Mesh. And we'll just leave the defaults for now and launch Play Mode. If we go in the console, we see that the rendering component has started loading our bundled data, so we just need to wait for this to complete. And once this is done, we see that our mesh is being rendered. And in the scene view, if I pan my camera around, we have these specular highlights appearing on the shiny surfaces of the captured environment. And using the unstructured lumigraph rendering algorithm, the interpolation between viewpoints appears quite natural. And we can modify several parameters here, for instance the number of cameras being blended together in each point, if we want the specular effects to be quite sharp, or on the contrary if we want the transition between viewpoints to appear smoother. I've now switched to VR, so I've scaled and moved the object to be able to move around it easily with my head-mounted display. And what I wanted to show here is that we're using an optimized version of the algorithm, which is optimized in two ways. A first optimization presented in the original paper on unstructured lumigraph rendering is to perform the heavy computations in the vertex stage of the shader, and interpolate them in the fragment stage, instead of performing them per fragment. So we've implemented this for this optimized version. And we've also added a custom optimization by which the heavy computations can be spread out over a given number of frames, which you can specify here. And this is what enables us to get VR-compatible frame rates. So if we activate the Unity statistics, we see that we are at hundreds of frames per second. And if we use the non-optimized version, this falls down to much lower frame rates, at which VR may be uncomfortable. So, if you're targeting virtual reality, you'll probably want to leave this on, and play with the different parameters. Otherwise, if you want higher quality results, know that you can always access the more precise version of the algorithm by turning this off. Okay, so we've reached the end of this tutorial. Thank you so much for watching, I hope this was useful for you. As always, feel free to give us your feedback on the project's GitHub page, and hopefully see you for the next tutorial.